Hello, and welcome back to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. Looks like we're getting that pretty big battle against the American Navy. A lot of these are... That's a lot of DDs, I'm not even gonna count them. Only one battleship though, but lots of heavy cruisers, and while many of them are the old, very obsolete Tennessee class, which I don't even think was good when they were first built. Some of them are the quite capable Langley class. So yeah, let's see how it goes. I've got four of my Derfflinger, two Derfflinger and two Star class battlecruisers. With 14 and 16 inch guns respectively, otherwise being identical pretty much. And we are already firing. Very nice. Hansa, you're quite old. You can detach and just follow the battlecruisers. I'm gonna slow my battlecruisers down to cruising speed. To gain as much accuracy as possible. And they're smoking up. What is my cruising speed? 18. I have no need for speed at the moment. I'm just gonna take it nice and slow. Some of these ships are on low fuel. Let's take a look. The DDs are on low fuel cruisers. That's one of the older. So the old heavy cruisers are fully fueled. Looks like the DDs and the newer heavy and light cruisers are on low fuel. Well, some of them. Okay. That must be the battleship. Wow, it's trash. I think. Should have decent tower spotting with those huge cage masts, but yeah, I don't think it's very good. First and foremost, target all my battle cruisers on the battleship. and then bring the ones with the 14-inch guns to target something else. Just so I can have the 16s focus the battleship. Oh yeah, new repair patch. So now the dialogue boxes actually fit the screen. All of them. I'm so proud of you, Game Labs. Ooh, what's this guy? What's this guy doing? Perhaps trying to launch torpedoes at me. You've not launched yet, which means you now will probably not live long enough to launch. Now you actually launched. At Württemberg. Speed up again. At 12.8 kilometer torpedoes. No, I think it actually launched torpedoes towards my heavy cruisers. Yes, okay. It was the guns that were targeted on my battle cruisers. For what good it did. Now that's fine. The Komoran class heavy cruisers can dodge torpedoes all day long. Just my battlecruisers that are kind of bad at it. To be completely honest. Because they are so long. Like even at reduced speeds like this, they don't dodge very well. Let's switch to these cruisers for a bit. Let's take a look at the Rhode Island. Expensive. Lots of armor. Deck armor, not that great. Coincidence too, for some reason. Oh, your main gun has exploded. Must have missed that. Cordite 1, picric acid 3. It's a wonder the whole ship didn't blow up. And you don't even have the range. Okay, so, yeah. No point in really focusing that ship until, it's time to just, kill it for victory points. Because it's literally not a threat. And it probably wouldn't have been, even, with ammo. These are all heavy cruisers. They do not have great torpedo range. They are slow and out of fuel. Bryant. Coming in. With torpedo range. That is something to be to respect. Even when not going fast, this DD pretty good at dodging, it seems. That's one heavy cruiser killed. First kill so far in this battle. That should be the end of the Bryant. That's one stupidly survivable DD. It's gone now. What was it made of? So it had maximum bulkheads. It's got some armor. Let's just quickly kill this so we can get closer to the enemy fleet. Flooding. Are you gonna sink soon? New Mexico? I think that's the last bit of flooding I needed. Yeah. These are quite old light cruisers. Four-kilometer torps, yeah. I can just have my two heavy cruisers take care of those. So DDs. Quite lucky with the weather, this battle. Of course, now I said that, it's probably gonna get foggy. Yeah, you got 12.6 kilometer torpedoes. Melinx. It's another one of those really... tanky DDs. I want you to stick to AP for firing at that guy. You got torpedoes. You're not like the others. Should have checked They all had the short-range torpedoes because that guy actually launched. Bunch of torpedoes. Luckily, I turned my whole division around, so they seem to not be going where I am. And as you see, dodging torpedoes, no problem for these cruisers. Now the Mullinx is out. For a while until it reloads. Now it's dead. Classes are this 7.3, same, that looks to be the same, yeah, with one triple launcher. Now these are the budget DDs. They're not that scary, do not have the same amount of torpedoes or the same torpedo range as this one. So that must be the Kuntz class. Two 16-inch armed. Battlecruisers firing at the battleship again. Because it's worth a lot. In terms of victory points. Almost forgot something something important. These do not have radar. Stereoscopic 2 on a modern heavy cruiser. What a waste! Gerben, please load AP for this. Bremerton. Get my heavy cruisers out of torpedo range of the Bremerton. Hansa has the right target. Yeah, Bremerton is going down. Very nice, very nice. Farenholt is one of those really tanky DDs. Starting to flood now. It's at 3% structural. There we go. Exploded. So that heavy cruiser ate a bit of a brick sandwich. These are more of the really tanky, kind of scary DDs. Launch must have been against my heavy cruisers. As did the other one. Very nice, must have been a torpedo detonation. Ammo detonation, yeah. And with its torpedoes on a reload, I'm just gonna charge in. And it's on low fuel, so it can't outrun me. Surrendered. Okay. Let's go and find the rest of the US Navy. And spend what I have left of ammunition. And Rhode Island is far away. So you're just gonna load HE for now. ~37 kilometer AP range. But we're closing in. And that battleship sure is not outrunning me. Let's actually pause to identify these DDs. Cheap, 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 and cheap. So, Kunze class, yeah. Target 1H. Do You have range to the battleship. Yeah, you do. This guy's flooding. These have few bulkheads. They're a bit easier to sink. Wow, it unflooded itself like magic. Did you see that? Buoyancy just went, whoop, nope. Anti-flood 3, though. Oh. Well, can't fix that. Not 18,000 damage from a 14-inch shell. Oh, no, no. Not all of you. I wish it was a little bit less sensitive. So you could actually select single ships within a division without having to pause the game. Slow down a bit. Yeah, it's almost as expensive as my battlecruisers. Not quite, but not far off. So actually knocking it out would give me decent victory point score. Which is ultimately the whole point of this battle. I want to make the Americans offer me a peace treaty. That's a good hit. I mean, it's still on 50% structural integrity, so... wouldn't get too much for just damaging it like this. It's just not that damaged. More flooding. I think that's it. I think it's sinking. Yes. Rhode Island sank. Goeben, Richmond, Star, Olympia. Ah, time. Well, I sank it before time ran out. Lots of ships left alive, though, but, two Tennessee class sunk, three Tennessee, and three Tennessee and two Langley class sunk, plus the battleship. And some light cruisers and DDs. I completely forgot about the timer. Agree. Do I get dragged into another war with China? Why, Mr. Army Commander General? Why are we doing this? See, those numbers make more sense. And this is ultimately also more useful. So I gotta check my army logistics. Still at 100. Transport capacity has actually increased a little bit. We might actually get Japan as an ally. That would be pretty nice. Where's our standing with China? Minus 75 victory points, because they've been sinking some transports, I guess. And Spain just got some victory points for sinking that submarine. Yeah. I think a combined force of, 850,000? Should be able to beat our combined force of, less than 800. So France is basically the country I want to keep fighting. Because I want this to succeed. That's like... Yeah. Britain fell apart. In case you missed that. That was not a surprise. And ultimately, even if I'd stopped the war against them, they would still have fallen apart. Let's do a naval invasion of Corsica, if possible. Yeah, we can do that. Move in support, because I think they need more submarine protections. And something against to protect from like minefields and stuff. That could work. I think I can hold. Oh, we've started also a major offensive against Nyasaland, former British colony. Okay. So that's the thing that popped up in the previous video, where it just said ungoverned territory and it didn't say where. So that's here. Okay, so that's like an automatic land invasion. So that means that maybe, hopefully, my armies in Britain can decide to invade northwest England and southern England. Maybe, hopefully. Now, all of this is gonna take very long time because my tech budget has been reduced. And it's been reduced because of transport losses. So that's just a reality right now. Yeah, also this is useless. Somehow my GDP started growing again, and it doesn't look like I lost any transports this turn. Yeah, we're gonna get more fights in the channel in the next episode, it seems. Should I send this out here? Yeah, let's send it out here and hope the Americans will pass through a minefield. Also, this might maybe work. Probably not. Tajikistan. Yeah, but currently France, main enemy, because I want this to succeed. And also, when possible, I want to try and improve relations to Austria-Hungary. Get them allied again, so they can join in on this. Anyway, that's it for this episode, I think. Oh, we got four DDs here. One in Hamburg. Two in Pillau. Let's send these out and then kind of just split them. And hunt some submarines. I think that's a not too bad idea. Alright, but yeah, that's it. Goodbye, and take care.